Hello, my dear children. Children, in the class today, we are going to study interference of waves. Well, children, we have already studied this interference of waves in class 11th. Now we are going to study interference of waves again, but in wave optics. So what is interference? Interference is a type of superposition of waves. And this is defined as superposition of waves having same frequency and constant phase difference. If the waves having same frequency and constant phase difference superpose on each other, intermingle with each other, overlap on each other, then what happens? The superposition is called as interference. So these two conditions are called as essential conditions. So essential conditions of interference are what? Same frequency and constant phase difference. And the sources which give out waves satisfying these conditions are called coherent sources. So light from coherent sources superpose and produces interference of waves. Well, what happens in interference? Well, in interference, the whole medium where the superposition takes place is divided into alternate regions of maximas and minimas. The whole medium where this superposition takes place is divided into alternate regions of maximas and minimas. These maximas are also called as bright bands. And these minimas are also called as dark bands. Remember, we called maximas as bright band, minimas as dark band only when it is interference of light waves. Otherwise, say in sound waves, the maximas are the positions where there is high intensity of sound, and minimas are those regions where there is very dim sound or no sound. The alternate arrangement of maximas and minimas which is created is called as interference pattern. Well, in interference of waves, no energy is created or destroyed. Interference is simply rearrangement of energy into maximas and minimas from two coherent sources. So the energy of coherent sources is rearranged, redistributed in the space, and as the result, maximas and minimas are created. No energy is created, no energy is destroyed. Law of conservation of energy holds true, and that is what is illustrated here. Well, in this diagram, the screen is divided into two parts. In one part, there is interference pattern, and in the other part, there is no interference pattern. Children, interference of waves produces maximas and minima. This is something very astonishing. But it doesn't happen in our day-to-day life. Suppose we have a tube light here, like this. And if we somehow get another tube light, which gives out the wave of same frequency and constant phase difference, then both the tube lights are going to be coherent sources. And then what will happen? The illumination throughout the room would be in the form of maximas and minimas. Everything in maximas, in bright bands, would be visible, and all those things which are in the minimas, dark bands, they would not be visible. So this is something very astonishing, but it happens. It happens only when there are two coherent sources. But remember, no two independent sources can ever be coherent. That is why in our day-to-day life, we do not see it. In our living room, we switch on one light, two light, three light, 10 lights, 20 lights. But we never see interference pattern formed. So for interference to be formed due to superposition of waves, well, the waves have to be from two coherent sources. And no two independent sources can ever be coherent. and in interference there is a redistribution of energy. And how is that? Let us see. Suppose we have two sources of intensity I naught each. These are two sources of intensity I naught each. If there is no interference, what will happen? One source is switched on. If one source is switched on, everywhere over the screen there will be intensity what? I naught, and so on. The intensity all over screen would be what? I naught, uniform intensity all over screen. And if one more source is switched on, simultaneously, then intensity all over screen becomes what? 2I0. If there are two identical sources switched on, the intensity everywhere in the room increases. That is what happens when there are two sources but they are not coherent. But if they happen to be coherent, then what happens? Well, maximas and minimas are created. If interference pattern takes place, the intensity in maxima is going to be what? 4I0, and in minima it would be 0. Again in maxima it would be 4I0, and minima it would be 0. 4I0, 0, 4I0, and 0. So whether interference takes place or not, the total I's over the screen, you can see, is same. This is 4, 4 is 16 I naught, and total I's here are, this is what, 16 I naught. So energy from this region shifts to this region. When interference takes place, energy from this region 2 I naught shifts to this region, and intensity here becomes what? 0, and intensity here becomes 4 I naught. And same thing happens in all maximas and all minimas. Okay children, let us treat interference mathematically. This is mathematical treatment of interference. This is a wave whose amplitude is A1, frequency, angular frequency omega. This is another wave whose amplitude is A2 and same frequency omega. But there is a phase difference, delta theta. This is phase difference. This is phase difference between the two waves. These are the waves coming from two coherent sources. Well, when they superpose over each other, principle of superposition of wave is followed. And according to principle of superposition of waves, net displacement is going to be vector sum of the displacement produced by each wave. So what is sum of these two vectors? What is sum of these two waves? Wave number one has amplitude A1, the other wave has amplitude A2. And the phase difference between them is what? Delta theta. So if this is A1, this is A2, the phase of wave 2 leads over phase of wave 1 by delta theta. So this delta A2 is made at an angle delta theta in anti-clockwise direction from A1. We have already studied phasor methods. So we can apply phasor method here also. Or you can do the vector sum which you have done already in class 11th. This is A1, this is A2. What is net displacement in the medium? Net displacement is going to be vector sum of these two amplitudes, and that is say A. So A is the amplitude of the resultant wave. What is this A? That A can be found out very easily. Just extrapolate this and drop normal from here. If this angle is delta theta, this angle is also going to be delta theta. If this length is A2, this length is going to be A2. Now look at this right angle triangle. In this right angle triangle, this base is going to be how much? This base is going to be A2 cos of delta theta. And this perpendicular is going to be what? A2 sin of delta theta. Now let us look at this big right angle triangle. In this right angle triangle, what is hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is A. The square of hypotenuse is going to be what? Sum of the squares of base and perpendicular. What is base? Base is right from here to here. This is base right from here to here. And what is this base? This base is going to be A1 plus A2 cos of delta theta. Base square, and then square of the perpendicular. What is that? A2 sin of delta theta whole square. And if we solve this, what do we get? We get A square as what? A1 square plus A2 square cos square theta and A2 square sin square theta. A2 square can be taken as common, sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. And the third term is what? 2A1 A2 cos of delta theta. So what is this A? This A is going to be square root of all this. That means amplitude of resultant wave is going to be square root of A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2 cos of delta theta. This is the resultant amplitude. This is the amplitude in interference pattern. And what is intensity? Since amplitude is direct, intensity is directly proportional to square of amplitude. So what is this? This intensity of wave number 1 is going to be directly proportional to square of amplitude of wave number 1. Intensity of wave number 2 is going to be directly proportional to square of amplitude of wave number 2. Square root of I1 is going to be what? Is going to be proportional to A1. And square root of I2 is going to be proportional to what? A2. Now let us substitute these values here in this result. See, A square can be replaced by some constant times I. This A1 square can be replaced by some constant times I1. This A2 square can be replaced by the same constant times what? I2. And what is this? 2A1 A2, that is 2 root of I1. For A1 it is what? Root of I1. For A2 it is what? Root of I2. And cos of delta theta. This is formula for intensity. Very, very important. This is formula for intensity in interference pattern. This is formula for amplitude in interference pattern. Well, remember, the constant of proportionality comes out common from both sides and cancels out. Yes, children. So we have just seen the amplitude in interference pattern is square root of A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2 cos delta theta. And intensity in interference pattern is I1 plus I2 plus 2 root I1 I2 cos of theta, cos of delta theta. Now let us see what happens in maxima. At maxima, this maxima is also called as bright band. We know it already. It is also called as constructive interference. All three have the same meaning. So at maxima or bright band or constructive interference, what happens is cos of delta theta is plus 1. Why? Because at maxima, amplitude has to be maximum. At maxima, intensity has to be maximum. And that is possible only when this term, cos of delta theta, is what? Plus 1. When cos of delta theta is plus 1, what happens? Yeah, the amplitude becomes what? Maximum. And what is that? If you write here plus 1, if you write this as plus 1, what is this? This is A1 plus A2 whole square, and whole square and square root will cancel out. And what do we get A max as? We get A max as A1 plus A2. This is maximum amplitude. Similarly, if we write here cos delta theta as plus 1, then what do we get? What is this? This is I max, and this maximum amplitude, intensity is going to be, what is this? This can be written as root I1 plus root I2 whole square. Just open up the bracket and see, it is same as this. Square of this is this, square of this is this, and twice this into this. So this is maximum amplitude, this is maximum intensity in constructive interference, bright band or maxima. But see children, it is happening only when cos of delta theta is plus 1. Cos of delta theta is plus 1, that means delta theta is going to be what? 0. Or it is going to be what? 2 pi. It is going to be 4 pi, 6 pi. and so on, say 2n pi. So this is what is phase. This is what is called as phase difference. This phase difference can also be written in term of path difference. This phase difference can also be written in term of path difference. And how do we write this as? See, this path difference can be written as delta x. So 0 phase difference is 0 path difference, 2 pi phase difference is lambda path difference, 4 pi phase difference is 2 lambda path difference, this is 3 lambda, and so on. What is this? N lambda. And whole of this condition can be written as, all this condition can be mathematically written like this: delta theta is equal to 2n pi, or delta x is equal to n lambda. This is condition for maxima. This is condition for, very important, this is condition for constructive interference, or condition for maxima, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. This n is different orders of maximas. N0 stands for central maxima. This is central maxima, central bright band. N1 stands for what? First maxima or first bright band. N2 stands for second maxima, and so on. So this n is nth order maxima. So this condition can be read as, this is condition for maxima, and this condition can be read as, wherever phase difference between the two waves is even multiple of pi, that is 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, and so on, even multiple of pi. So wherever phase difference between the two waves is even multiple of pi, or path difference is integral multiple of lambda, there takes place constructive interference. And when constructive interference takes place, the two waves meet like this. Yeah, this is wave number one. This is wave number one, say of amplitude A1. And this is wave number two, whose amplitude is what? A2. So the two waves meet like this. The loop of one lies above another. And that way what happens, the net amplitude everywhere, this is A1, this is A2, and A1, A2, they are what? In the same direction. So net displacement everywhere is what? In the same direction. And the net wave, the resultant wave, is going to be what? The wave like this. And everywhere, what is amplitude? A1 plus A2. Everywhere the amplitude is what? The sum of A1 and A2. This is what is called as same phase superposition. We call it as same phase superposition. Same phase superposition. And mathematical condition for same phase superposition is this. The phase difference between the waves in same phase superposition is either 0 or 2 pi, 4 pi, or even multiple of pi. Or path difference between the wave is what? 0, lambda, 2 lambda, or integral multiple of lambda. Now let us see what happens in minima. So in minima, or say at minima, dark band or destructive interference, all the three means same. So at minima, dark band or destructive interference, all three means the same. And over here, the cos of delta theta has minimum value, -1. We have just seen there, if the cos theta is +1, the intensity is going to be maximum. But if the cos c delta theta is going to be what? -1. Both intensity and amplitude would be what? Minimum. And if we write here what? If we write here -1, if we write minus one here, these signs would be what? Negative. And these expressions are what? The expressions for minimum amplitude and minimum intensity. What is minimum amplitude? Minimum amplitude is going to be what? Yeah. Minimum amplitude is going to be what? This expression. And this is the expression for minimum intensity. What is minimum amplitude? It is A1 difference A2. This is the square root of what? A1 minus A2 whole square, or A2 minus A1 whole square. And that is what is written as A1 difference A2. and minimum intensity is going to be what? Root of I1 minus root of I2 whole square. So these are the expressions for minimum amplitude in interference pattern and minimum intensity in interference pattern. These expressions are found from that general expression by substituting cos delta theta as minus 1. Well, when cos of delta theta is minus 1, that is possible only when, that is possible only when delta theta is what? Pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, see, cosine function is periodic function and the period is what? 2 pi, 7 pi and so on, 2n minus 1 pi. This is phase difference. This phase difference can be written in term of path difference as what? Path difference as delta x. And what is that? Lambda phase pi phase difference is lambda by 2 path difference. 3, this is 3 lambda by 2 path difference. This is 5. For pi we are writing what? Lambda by 2. And so on, 2n minus 1. For pi we write what? Lambda by 2. And this condition can be written as delta theta. Delta theta is equal to 2n minus 1 pi. Or delta x can be written as 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. This is mathematical condition for destructive interference. This is condition for minima. And this condition can be read as, this condition can be read as wherever phase difference between the waves is odd integral multiple of pi, pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, odd integer, odd integral multiple of pi, or path difference is odd integral multiple of lambda by 2, 1 lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, 5 lambda by 2, minima is formed there. So wherever phase difference between the wave is odd integral multiple of pi, or path difference is odd integral multiple of lambda by 2, minima is formed there. And in this generalized condition, n is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. What are these 1, 2, 3 and 4? These are orders, various orders of minimas. N is equal to 1 means first minima, n is equal to 2 means what? Second minima and so on. These are orders of various minimas. Now, what happens when the waves meet like this? When waves meet in destructive interference, the waves superpose on each other like this. This is wave number 1. This is wave number 1. Say this wave has amplitude A1. This is another wave whose amplitude is what? This is another wave, say its amplitude is what? A2. This is A1 and this is A2. This is what is called as opposite phase. Opposite phase superposition. Opposite phase superposition. So when the wave meet in opposite phase, their loops are just opposite of each other. Loop of one wave is like this and the other wave is like this. And as the result, what happens? The net displacement is always in opposite direction. Net displacement is simple difference, and displacement produced by both the waves is always in opposite direction. Here in same phase, the displacement everywhere were in the same direction, but here the displacements are in opposite direction. Wave number 1, the displacement is upward, and wave number 2, displacement downward. So net displacement is always there, simple difference. Yeah, always there, simple difference. This one, and this is going to be your resultant wave. So this red one, this is your resultant wave, the red one, which is the difference of the two everywhere. So this is condition for minima, and that's how the wave superpose over each other in minima. So children, with this we come to the end of the basic concepts which we have already studied in class 11th related with interference. So we have finished the interference which we studied in class 11th. Now we are going to study further in the next lecture the applications of interference. We'll study Young double slit experiment, we'll study various other experiments. So this is all as far as basic of interference are concerned. Thank you very much and God bless you all.